All right, please take your seat. Earlier we have read about the four part consciousnesses, and now these are the five jhana sotapatti mega chaitas. So when the part consciousness is associated with the jhana chaita, so we have to mention the jhana first. So this jhana, the name of the jhana here is just like the name of the we have seen the name of the jhana. Like we say, vitaka, vichara, piti, sukha, ekagata, sahidam, patamach jhana. So this is the first jhana, the name of the first jhana. Then we just combine with sotapatti mega chaitam. So the first jhana, sotapatti part consciousness, together with the five jhana factors. Now we already know initial obligation, sustained obligation, joy, bliss, and one-pointedness. Then we eliminate vitaka, so we get vichara, piti, sukha, ekagata, sahidam, dutiyach jhana, sotapatti, mega chaitam. Again, eliminate vichara, piti, sukha, ekagata, sahidam, tatiyach jhana, sotapatti, mega chaitam. Again, eliminate piti, sukha, ekagata, sahidam, chatutach jhana, sotapatti, mega chaitam. Then eliminate sukha and put in upikha, upikha ekagata sahitam, patamach jhana sotapatti mega chaitam. So not the names, so it would be on the next page. So that fifth jhana chaita, we know the name, we say the fifth jhana sotapatti part consciousness, together with equanimity and one-pointedness. So these are the names of the part consciousnesses. Then we give you the name of the resultant consciousnesses. So again, we have, as we have four part consciousness, we also have four part resultant consciousness. So basically, there are only four Logutra Vipaka Chaita as the fruitions of the four Logutra Kusala Chaita. So we have to change only Kusala to Vipaka. These four types of supramundane resultant consciousnesses are realized in the Vipassana Yanika way. So in the Vipassana Yanika way, the part consciousness are not associated with the jhana, so there are only four of them. Sotapatti phala chaitam. So no, phala and resultant means the same thing. Sotapatti fruit. No, so the fruit consciousness we will say here. So skadami phala chaitam is so skadami fruit consciousness. So in the meaning, consciousness belonging to the fruition of stream entry. The second one, consciousness belonging to the fruition of one's returning. And how about the third, jhana chaita, chaita, anagami phala chaita, it is anagami fruit consciousness, consciousness belonging to the fruition of never returning. And then arata, phala chaitam, is arahata, fruit consciousness, consciousness belonging to the fruition arahatship. So as you know, no, the Sotapatti, now we go to the jhana, resultant consciousness. So we have here, so we give you, no, the five arahata, arahata phala citta. So, no, the last citta actually. So we read together now. Vitaka, vichara, piti, sukha, ekagada, sahidam, patamach jhana, arahata phala citta. And vichara, piti, sukha, ekagada, sahidam, dutiyach jhana, arahata phala citta. Piti sukha ekagada sahidam tatya jhana arata phala chaitam sukhe ekagada sahidam chatutha jhana arata phala chaitam upikha ekagada sahidam panchama jhana arata phala chaitam. So the meaning, the first jhana arata, fruit consciousness, together with initial obligation, sustained obligation, joy, bliss, and one-pointedness. And the second, jhana arahata, fruit consciousness, together with sustained obligation, joy, bliss, and one-pointedness. The third, jhana arahata, fruit consciousness, together with joy, bliss, and one-pointedness. The fourth, jhana arahata, fruit consciousness, together with bliss and one-pointedness. And the fifth jhana arahata, fruit consciousness, together with equanimity and one-pointedness. So we give the name, all the names of the chaita. So now we finished, no, teaching the chaita, but we still have quick review on consciousness. So you better look at the chart number one, no? So, and then for us, we go to the, so let them look at the first, the chart number one, no, the citta chart. So in the chart, we describe, no, 12 immoral minds, akusala citta. So they consist of 8 lobha mula chaita, 2 dosa mula chaita, and 2 moha mula chaita. No, you should practice writing, no, the names of these chaita. No, and then the second group, we call it the rootless consciousness, ahituka chaita. So they comprise 7 akusala vipaka chaita, 8 ahituka kusala vipaka chaita, and 3 arata kriya chaita. So you should practice writing the names of these things so that you can remember very well. And then if you intend to appear for the examination, so we have to write down this name, no, both in Pali, no, especially in Pali. And then, no, so we go to the next page. So in the next page, no, we have number 3. So in the chart number 1, it will be, no, the third group. The third group is, we call kama sovana chaita, sense fear. No, kama is sense fear. Beautiful consciousness, there are 24 of them. So they consist of 8 mahakusala chaita, no, 8 maha vipaka chaita, and 8 maha kriya chaita. And then the next group, or we combine these 3 groups, those we call them kama vachara chaita, sensory consciousness. So altogether there are 54, no, comprising 12 akusala chaita, 18 rootless consciousness, ahituka chaita, and 24 sensory. No, so these are the beautiful consciousness. Sobhana is beautiful consciousness. So we see how many Kama, Vajra, Vipaka, Chittas are there. So how do you, you look at it? So in chart number one, now you have to show the chart number one. No? Okay, here. So we have done the 12 immortal mind, 18 rootless consciousnesses, and then 24, no, karma, sovana, chitta. So when you ask, no, in this karma, chitta, up to here, so how many agusala chitta? 12. How many kusala chitta? Only 8. And how many vipaka chitta? So here we have vipaka. 7 plus 8, 15 plus 8, 23 chaita, we say. And then how many kriya chaita? 3 plus 8, 11. No? Then we go to the next topic. So we give you this topic. Mahagata jhana chaita. No? Mahagata. So when we come to this, no, the here. Rupa Vajra Kusala Chaita, Rupa Vajra Kisala Chaita, remember they are Jhana Chaita. So the 15, no, the Rupa Vajra Jhana Chaita, and the 12 are Rupa Vajra Jhana Chaita. So, no, together they are called 27 Mahakata Jhana. No, Mahakata means more developed and more exalted, no, more noble than Kama Vajra Chaita. So no, we get 27 here. So in the 15 Rupa Vajra Jhana, what Chaita are there? So there are 5 Rupa Vajra Kusala Chaita, no, 5 Rupa Vajra Vipaka Chaita, and 5 Rupa Vajra Kriya Chaita. And in the 12 Arupa Vajra Chaita, we have 4 Arupa Vajra Kusala, 4 Arupa Vajra Vipaka, and 4 Arupa Vajra Kriya. Now, these 5 Rupa Vajra Kusala Chaita and 4 Arupa Vajra Kusala Chaita, together, they are called 9 Mahagata Jhana Chaita. So we have to take this one, 9 Mahagata Jhana Chaita. Similarly, there are 9 Mahagata Vipaka Chaita and 9 Mahagata Kriya Chaita. No? So we should go like that. And then we, when we, no, we combine these 27 and with this 54 Rupa Vajra, Kama Vajra Chaita, 27 plus 54, will give you 81. So we call them Lokiya Chaita. No? Lokiya, no, means, no, 3 spheres. That is, no, sense sphere, this is sense sphere, and fine material sphere, and immaterial sphere. So the Chaita that arise in its 3 spheres, no, we also say Triloka. No? So there are how many Chaita? 81. 81 chaita. And now in this 81 chaita, no, they will ask you, how many agusala chaita? Again 12. And how many kusala chaita? You get 8 here and 9. 8 plus 9, 17. No, 17 kusala chaita. So you also read at the book, no? We also give you this thing. And then, how many vipaka chaita? So we say we have 23 here, plus 9, 32. No, 32 vipaka chaita. How many kriya chaita? 11, plus 9, 20. Okay? No? Now we add again. Now if we add this, the 8 Lukutara Chaita, now in the Vipassana Yanika way, we also say this in the brief method, there are 8 Lukutara Chaita. So in the broad method, or in the Samatha Yanika route, there are 40 Lukutara Chaita. So, if you add this 81 with this 8, you get how many? 89. That is the two-dot number of consciousnesses in the brief method or in the Vipassana Yanika way or route. No? And if you add this the 81 Logia Chaita with the 40, no, the Lugutra, the Lugutra Jhana Chaita, you will get 121. That is the total Chaita in the broad method or in the Samatha Yanika route or way. No, so okay. Now, in the brief method, again they will ask you, no, how many akusala chaita, no, in the brief method, the total chaita, so up to here, no, up to here. So how many chaita do we have? Only 12. And how many kusala chaita? Remember, we get 32 here, no, or there is 17 here, no, 8 plus 9, 17, and now plus 4. You get 21. No, you get 21. The moral mind. And the vipaka chaita. So how many? So remember we get, no, in the logia chaita we get 32. Now you combine with 4. So you get 36. And the kriya chaita, no, remains 20. No, 20. Now in the broad method. No, this method, in the 121 chaita. So how many akusala chaita? Again, 12. And kusala chaita? So now this 17 should be added with this 20 here. So you get 37. No? 17 plus 20, you get 37. And then vipaka chaita, in the logia, we get 32, remember? 32 plus 20? 52, and Lugutra Kriya Chaita is again 28. Then in our book, okay, will you please show the. So now we already said about 27 Mahakata Chaita, 81 Lugia Chaita, and 8 or 40, no, now the Lugutra Chaita. We already finished up to here. Now, Asobana Chaita here. No? Asobana Chaita means not beautiful consciousness. Remember, there are 30 of them comprising 12 Akusala Chaita and 18 Ahetuka Chaita. No? They are called not beautiful consciousness. And these, no, the 12 Akusala Chaita, they are not beautiful because they are associated with evil roots. Namely, lobha, dosa, and moha. No, greed, anger, and delusion or ignorance. And the ahetuka chaitas are regarded as not beautiful. No, asopana is not beautiful because they are not associated with, no, beautiful roots. So the beautiful roots are lobha, generosity, dosa, goodwill, moha, wisdom. So when a lady, no, didn't put up any makeup or any, no, the other ornament, she looks not very beautiful. So when you, no, apply the makeup and all these things, the beautiful thing, she looks very beautiful. The same thing here. As they are not associated with the beautiful roots, we call them not beautiful consciousnesses. No? So, and then if you subtract this 30 asobana chaita, no, from the total chaita, how many total chaita we have? So 89 or 121. So if you subtract 30 from 89, you get 59. And if you subtract 30 from 121, you get 91. We say these are beautiful consciousnesses. No? So 30 are not beautiful, and these 59 or in the brief method, And 91, in the broad method, they are beautiful consciousness. Why are they called beautiful? They associate with beautiful roots. They associate with beautiful roots. So, no, the beautiful roots are all this one. Alopa, we say, you know, this beautiful wood. So in that wholesome, it should be used, no? The beautiful is better. Sobana means beautiful. So alopa, adosa, amoha, they associate with them. Now, if we, so we already we get this now. Now we have, we get this, that, no? How many jhana chaitas, no? All together? 67. How do you get this 67? So you have to look in your chart again. No, in your chart, so we have 27. No, here 27 is Mahagata Jhana. So no, they belong to the Logia Chaita. So among the Logia Chaita, no, mundane consciousness, we can say Logia Chaita, there are 27, no, Jhana Chaita. And in the supramundane, no, consciousnesses, there are 40. 40 plus 27, we get 67 jhana chaita. So now again, among these 67 jhana chaita, how many are first jhana? How many are second jhana? So no, they can also ask like that. So in other words, to know about Abhidhamma in detail, no, you have to know about these things. So again, no, you, we can see here. Now we begin with the five Rupa Vajra Kusala Chaita. Remember, no, in these five chaita, there is one first jhana, one second jhana, one third jhana, one fourth jhana, one fifth jhana. The same thing, no, with the five Vipaka Chaita and five Kriya, no, the Logutra, the Rupa Vajra Kriya Chaita, the same. So how many first jhana chaita then? No, 1, 1, 1, you get 3 first jhana. The same thing, 3 second jhana, 3 third jhana, no, not Mahakusala, it should be here. No, 3 first jhana, 3 second jhana, 3 third jhana, 3 fourth jhana, 3 fifth jhana. 3 into 5, you get 15, together 50. And all the 12 in the, no, the Arupa Vajra Kusala Chaita, they are grouped together with the fifth Rupa Vajra Jhana, with the fifth jhana, because they have the same jhana factor, no, Upika Ikekada. So now we see, no, these 12 in moral minds are developed based on the fifth Rupa Vajra Jhana. So they belong to the same, no, category. So the fifth Rupa Jhana is also, no, Upika Ikekda. So they also have Upika Ikekda. So there are 3, no, the fifth jhana here, and there are 12, if you combine together, you get 15. No, 15. So now remember, we have 3 first jhana, 3 second jhana, 3 jhana, 3 fourth jhana, and 15 fifth jhana chaita, okay? No? Now, in the Logutra chaita, so remember we have this as, no, again the first jhana, no? Pathama is first jhana, second jhana, third jhana, fourth jhana, fifth jhana. And the same thing here. So how many first jhana chaita here? 4. Also 4 here. So if you combine, you get 8 first jhana. The same thing, you get 4 and 4 second jhana. So also 8 second jhana, 8 third jhana, 8 fourth jhana, 8 fifth jhana, 8 each. Okay? Okay or not? Now we add these 3 first jhana with this 8 first jhana, we get how many? 11 first jhana chaita. So in the same way, no, there are three second jhana and eight second jhana, you also get 11 second jhana. The same thing, 11th jhana, 11th foot jhana, and in the fifth jhana, no, we say you have to add also this 12 in moral mind. Remember, we have 15 here, fifth jhana. If you eight with eight, you get how many? 23. No, so that these are the number of jhana. So what is our the next topic? So you have to. So we finish here, no? So 11 first jhana, 11 second jhana, 11 third jhana, 11 fourth jhana, and 23 fifth jhana. So no, we have already counted here. Now the next one is division according to jati. Jati is bat, no, we call it. The chittas are divided into four classes according to jati, no, according to bat, namely. So we have, no, the four bhariko column, remember, akusala, kusala, vipaka, and kriya chaita. No, so according to bat, so the chaitas are, no, described into four kinds. Akusala chaita, kusala chaita, vipaka chaita, and kriya chaita. So we say by looking at chat number one, we can divide, no, 54 kama vajra chaitas into 12 akusala chaita, 8 kusala chaita, 23 vipaka chaita, and 11 kriya chaitas according to birth. No? The 23 vipaka chaita are collectively named as kama vipaka chaita, and 11 kriya chaita are known as, oh, okay. Okay, we show chart number one. So now we say, no, the four kinds of chaita according to bhata are akusala, kusala, vipaka, and kriya. No, so remember, no, akusala chaita and kusala chaita, they have karma properties. No, they have karma properties. Vipaka chaitas are the resultant of these, no, kusala karma. So they don't have karma property, and also, no, the result of kusala karma as well as the akusala karma. This is the result of akusala karma. So vipaka chaita do not have karma properties, and functional consciousnesses, they arise in the arahats. So, no, they also have no karma properties. No, now we say when we divide, no, the karma vajra chaita. So, no, according to what we say, so, no, so it is asked in the question and exam. So they say, you please divide the 54 kama vachara chaita, no, according to what. So then we have to say 12 akusala chaita. And how many are the kusala chaita? How many? So up to here, only, you just look up to here, only 8. And then vipaka chaita, 7. Plus 8, 15, plus 8, 23, no, 23 kama vajra chaita. And then kriya chaita, 3 plus 8, 11 kama vajra chaita. Then we say, now if you combine this 54 kama vajra chaita together with the mahakata chaita, no, 27, so you get 81 lokiya chaita. Now, if you ask, now, no, try to divide the chaita, no, the 81 lokiya chaita according to bhat. So then you have to, no, to consider up to here. So how many akusala chaita? 12. How many kusala chaita? Remember, we get 17, no, up to here. 17. How many vipaka chaita? We already got before. So you get, no, you get 32 plus 9 here. How many? Here 23 plus 9, 32, no, 32 vipaka chaita. And for kriya chaita, 11 plus 9, so 20, no, 20. And then, if you add no, the 8 chaita to the logia chaita, you get this, no, the total chaita, 89. So what would be the division into according to birth? Again, you get 12 here, and then Kusala Chaita is 21, and then Vipaka Chaita, 32 plus 4, you get 36, and the Kriya Chaita is again 30. And how about this, the total, no, the 121? So remember, we get these are the total number, 12, and then Kusala is 37, Vipaka 52, Kriya 28. And then the last topic we have. No, division according to feeling. Division according to feeling. The next one. So no, we have here. Division according to Vedana, feeling. So remember in the Chitta chart we have 5 types of feeling. So what are they? Please read. Somanasa is pleasant mental feeling. Domanasa is painful mental feeling. Sukha is pleasant bodily feeling. Dukkha is painful bodily feeling. Upika, neutral feeling. Now we make a chart here. We make a chart here. So the name of the chaitas are given here. And then these are the somanasa, domanasa, upekha, sukha, dukkha. So if you look in your citta chart, so in the citta chart, how many do you get in they ask you now, row by row. So among the kusala chaita, akusala chaita, so how many somanasa? Only 4? Yes. No, somanasa 4, and the upika 4 plus 2, 6, and domanasa 2. No, so we put in here. No, we put in that number 4. Somanasa, 2 domanasa, 6 upika, no sukha and no dukkha. Now we do the same with the ahiduka. So can you look in your chart and see how many somanasa? Only 2. Can you see? And upika 14, 1 sukha, 1 dukkha, and 18 chaita. Can you get it? All right. So otherwise, we have to see the chart, the first chart again, chart number 1. No. So among these, you have only 2 somanasa here. No, this plus here 2, and then 1 dukkha, 1 sukha. So 2 plus 2, you get 4. You subtract 4 from the 18. So that gives you the upika 14, no? So already. And then when we come to the 24, no? The kama sobana chaita. So it is easy here, no? They have only here 4 somanasa altogether, 12 somanasa and 12 upika, only that. And how about in the mahagata chaita? How many somanasa? Again, 12 somanasa. And how many upika? Here 3 plus 12, 15. Okay? So we look here again. No? So now for the kama chitta. For kama chitta, we combine all these 3. And then we get 18, 2, 23, 1, 54. Now the Mahagata Chaita, we say No, we have 12 somanasa and 15 upekkha. And then you combine again. No, you combine this 18, 12, you get 30. 2 and then 47, this is the lokiya chaita. No, you get, so 81 is lokiya chaita. Now in the Lukutra chaita, in the brief method, no, we have only four. We don't use the Lukutra in the brief method. Only we take in the broad method. So in the broad method, how many Lukutra chaita? No, the Lukutra chaita among somanasa. So remember, we have very easy. So the chaita chart again. Remember in the brief method, no, the Lukutra chaitas are given the sign plus or minus. So that means, no, these part consciousnesses and fusion consciousness can associate, no, either with the somanasa or upekkha. So when you are meditating, no, undertaking insight meditation joyfully, then when you get the Lukutra chaita, it associate with the somanasa, no, somanasa feeling. So if you are meditating only, no, with upekkha consciousness, so then, no, the Lukutra chaita will be upekkha sagatam. So we omit them, no, because they are not definite according to the feeling. But the broad method is definite. So you get, no, the 4 plus 4, 4 times. So 4 times, 16. And also 16 plus here. Altogether 32, somanasa, and 4 and 4 here, 8 upekkha. So that's we put in here. So 32, somanasa, 8 upekkha. So the total, what do you have? No, so here 62 somanasa, 2 domanasa, 55 upekkha, 1 sukha, 1 dukkha, and this is the total number of, no, the total number is 121. So, no, in the examination, they used to ask, now try to analyze, no, they say, no, the 81 lokiya chaitas, no, according to feeling. So you have to give this this number. So, no, if you are asked, it has been asked in the examination. So how do you remember this this number? If you don't, you are not allowed to see the chart. Just with remembrance, you cannot get it. So what we did is this way. Say we say, U chatu sata, so timsa, do dwa su du ek. U means upekkha, no, upekkha. Upekkha chatu sata. So now you have to know the Pali word. Chatu means four. Now in the sata mean sata, seven. So now the upekkha 47. So timsa, so manasa, timsa means 30. So somanasa 30 here. And do dwa, do is do manasa. Dwa means do. No, the dwa, dui. So they mean two. And then su, sukha, du, dukha. Ek means ika. Ika means one. So sukha one. Sukha one, dukha one. So if I remember this, you can write down the answer. And also for the total, no, the chaita, analysis of the total chaita, so we all also give, no, the verse here. We say, upan che che, so cha dui, do dui su du ek. Oh, so you can remember very easily. Though I appear for the examination, about 30 years ago, I can remember. I can still remember. U pan che che. U mean ubika. Pan che che mean pancha pancha. 55. Pancha pancha 55. 55. No? So ubika 55. So somnasa timsa. So here. So cha dui. Cha chatama. Chatama in Pali is 6. Dwe also mean 2, 62. Do dwe, so do domnasa, dwe is 2, and su du ek is sukha 1, dukha 1. Well, we finished the chaita chat now. So, I just regard you pass the examination. So, we go to chat number 2 now. So chapter 2, please. So no, page 60. So in chapter 2, we have the chance to study about mental factors. No, remember there are 52 mental factors and 13 are neutral. No, the 14 are akusala. And then in moral, and 25 are beautiful. Sobhana means beautiful. And we have to begin from this. So if you are asked, what is the meaning of the mental factor? So what is mental factor? So in Pali we call it the sika. So if you say what is mental factor? No, so we have to answer. So mental factor, so just read. Chetasika are mental factors, are mental concomitants that arise and perish together with consciousness. No, concomitant means those that arise together are called concomitants. No? So they arise, the mental factor, they arise and perish together with consciousness. And they depend on consciousness for their arising. No? And they influence the mind to be bad, good, neutral as they arise. And to be called, a mental factor, they must also have the four characteristic property. So, this is the meaning of the mental factor. When you say what are chetasika, so now, you can say the chetasikas are concomitants. Concomitant means they arise together, that arise and perish together with consciousness. And they depend on consciousness for their arising, and they influence the mind to be bad and good or neutral as they arise. And they also have the following four characteristics, characteristic properties. And we say, so they arise together with consciousness, and they perish together with consciousness, and they take the same sense object which the consciousness takes. And they share a common physical base with the consciousness. So now for a consciousness to arise, they have to depend on a physical base, we call vatu. And they also have to take a sense object. Only then they can arise. So consciousness cannot arise alone. Chetasika cannot arise alone because they are very subtle and very tender. They have to combine together for their arising. So now this is the meaning of the chetasika. And I ask you here, which is more powerful, the consciousness or the mental factors? As the consciousness and mental factor, they arise together to form the mind, and we say the mind is the most powerful in the world, in the universe, It is the most powerful, actually, the mind. No? It is the mind that produces all atomic bombs and all hydrogen bombs. So that is according to science. No? They say, we can say the mind is most powerful. But in Abhidhamma, we shall learn that it is the mind, no, that creates all living beings. All living beings are created by the mind. No? So we have no concrete evidences about these things. No? And then no, they create the living beings, all living beings, not human beings, all living beings are created by the mind. And then it is the mind that not that con, that that the condition or determine the fates and fortunes of all living beings. All living beings. So no, if we know that, so the mind is the most powerful. No, we can agree. So just no, so when we say no, the which is more powerful, consciousness window factor, as they cannot arise alone and they have to walk together, so no, we say they are equally powerful. Okay, you just read there. And now we have here, no, there are how many neutral mental factors? 13. And remember, they are our essential qualities. No, we need them, no, for our existence. And then akusala citta is immoral mental factors. So there are 14. They are our bad qualities. So you should know these bad qualities. So now if you are just developing the bad qualities, you also have the bad character. No, you, and then you will perform only wicked things, immoral things, and you will be the born in woeful state when you die. And sobhana chitta-sika are beautiful mental factors, 25 of them, and they are our good qualities, so we should develop them. No, then only we shall also become more noble and also more beautiful. No? Okay. We begin with the 13 neutral mental factors. So in Pali, we call Anya Samana Chedasika. Now the 13 Anya Samana Chedasikas can associate both with Sobhana, no, beautiful consciousnesses, and Asobhana, not beautiful consciousnesses. No, that means they can associate with all consciousnesses actually. And they are neutral and they enhance the properties of the chitta-sikas with which they associate. We can use them for, so if we can use them for good purposes, they are very beneficial for us. Very beneficial for us. Now, they are again divided into two subgroups. One is sabba citta sadharana. Sabba means all. Citta means consciousness. Sadharana means associate. So we say they associate with all consciousnesses. So we also call them essential mental factors. No? Essential mental factors. They associate with all consciousness. So no, the consciousness must combine with them for their arising. Okay, we go to the next. And then we get the second group is called Pakinagas. In Pali, in English, we call them particular mental factors. No? Essential mental factors and particular mental factors. So, no, they selectively associate with some beautiful consciousness as well as with some not beautiful consciousness. So these six mental factors, they don't associate with all the chitta, they associate only with some particular consciousness with which they associate. So they are called particular mental factors. So we give you first the names of the first group we call essential mental factor. Remember, now the first group is called essential mental factors, and you should know that all consciousnesses, they must associate with these seven mental factors. So these seven, the sabba citta sadharana associate collectively, No, they associate collectively, all of them, they associate together with all consciousnesses. Consciousness of an object, no, by citta is accomplished with the help of these citta-sika. So they have the consciousness to be aware of each sense object. So, no, at first you should know the essential meaning. At least you should know the essential meaning on this much. And then we give you, no, the broader description here. So to know, no, to know about these citta-sikas quite, no, comprehensively. So we read them. So, no, in Pali we call it passa. No, passa, vedana, sanya, cetana, ekekada, jivitindriya, and manasikara. So passa means contact or mental impression, no? And then vedana is feeling or sensation. Sanya is perception, cetana is volition or intention, and ekagata is one-pointedness, and we also call it concentration, samadhi. And jivitindriya is psychic life or life faculty. No, jivita is actually life in me, no? Jivita is life. And indriya is faculty, so also called life faculty. And then manasikara is attention or reflection. No, so this is the essential meaning. So we don't know very well, no, what they mean actually. So when we come here, we know the meaning, no, quite well. So passa is, no, the literally it means the contact. So what is this contact? Passa furnishes the contact between the sense object and the consciousness. For example, the contact between visible object and eye consciousness, no, chakku vijnana is eye consciousness, is accomplished by passa. So without passa, there will be no sense impression, and, no, consequently, no cognition. Passa produces feeling, and this is very important also. No, so we send what the mental impression is, you know, like we say the sense impression like this here. And then there is one good question. Where does consciousness and mental factors exist? We ask you. No? And we you should say that mental factors and consciousness do not exist anywhere. Do not exist anywhere. Because as soon as they arise, they finish. No, they perish. As soon as they arise, they perish. No? So they don't exist anywhere, we say. And how do they arise? It's another question. And then we give you, no, the example of striking image. So this is the matchbox, and this is the match stick. So when you strike the match there, you get the flame, no, comes out at the striking point. Where this flame comes from? From the matchbox? No. From the match stick? No. Where? So because of the striking of the two, no, we can see, no, the flame arises. And then the flame, no, of that it arises, it perishes. So where does it go? Where does it go? It disappears. So it just perishes, we say. No, it does not go anywhere. Just like that. No, the consciousness arises by the striking of the sense object at the sense door. No, so sense door, sense object. The eye door, so this is visible object. If strike here, so at the striking point, eye consciousness and association mental factors arise. No, so very, very, so quite, no, quite meticulous actually. No, they don't exist anywhere. When you, no, they come in contact, So at the point of contact, eye consciousness, when eye consciousness arises, remember, it must associate with the mental factors. So all the mental factors and consciousness, they arise together. And soon after they arise, they perish. And then to see this sense object, that eye consciousness and together with the mental factors, they must come in contact with the visible object. And now, consciousness and mental factors are mentality. They are mental, we call the eye, the eye consciousness. Actually, it is the mind. Combination of consciousness and mental factor, actually it is the mind. That arises in the eye. So that mind is mentality. And visible object is materiality. So how can they come in contact? Though they are together, they cannot come in contact yet. So it needs the pasa. Pasa also arises at the same time. Pasa makes the contact between that consciousness and visible object. Only then the consciousness can be aware of this visible object. So it is just like if you have the stem, so you beat on the paper, the stem appears there. The same thing, because of pasa, the visible object, like you put the stem on the consciousness, so consciousness appears in the eye consciousness. So we can remember like that, so, and that's why we give you, it is mental impression, produced by the contact. So when the contact between consciousness and consciousness and the eye door, and then that contact also produce feeling or sensation. And remember, this feeling is very, very important for all living beings, we might say. There are five types of feeling, we already see. So the somanasa is pleasant mental feeling, sukha is pleasant bodily feeling. And then dukkha is painful bodily feeling, and it can also mean painful mental feeling. So all living beings do not like the painful feeling, they like the pleasant feeling. And actually, when we are enjoying the sense of pleasure, not just when we are watching the movie, for example. So when we are enjoying the movie, so what citta arises in our mind? Yesterday we already made the exercise. We what citta it is? So when we enjoy sense pleasure, we enjoy with greed, rooted consciousness. Lobhamula citta, Lobhamula citta. So we see with eye consciousness. Remember that the cognitive series, jhavana citta. So after you see it, the jhavana citta arises in chart number 9. We show you. So we say, the sense object strikes the eye door, we say. So at the striking point, the eye consciousness and mental factors arises. And then they arise at the point where the sense object strike and appear. So sense object is there, and eye consciousness also arises there. And pasa make them the contact. So we say consciousness sees the object. Sees the object, but it has to be the process step by step to be known. So consciousness just sees just one moment, and we don't know it yet. So it is received by somebody chana chitta, and investigated by sandhidana chaita, and determined by vatthapana chaita. No, it is the manodvara vajna chaita. And according to this, no, the decision, when you make the decision, if you can make wise reflection, we say, no, the kusala chaita will arise here. If you make unwise reflection, immoral consciousness will arise here. So when you are watching the movie, what is your decision? What is your decision when you see the actors and actresses? Oh, they are so beautiful, so handsome. Oh, so nice to see them. So if you, no, you decide like that, lobha mula chaita will arise. So we say lobha chaita will arise here. No, will arise here, lobha mula chaita. No? And then left lobha mula chaita. If the, no, the if the sense object is, no, the beautiful and appreciated, no, you decide it to be very beautiful, then we say, no, that the pleasant feeling will arise. So that pleasant feeling is the, no, enjoyed by this lobha mula chaita, and then we call it we are enjoying the sensual pleasure. So actually sensual pleasure, no, enjoyment of sense pleasure is enjoyment of the feeling, no, with the great-rooted consciousness. And when you have somanasa, sagadam, it also associated with joy. No, so piti, joy, and these sukha, pleasant feeling. So that represents the sensual pleasure. No, so this sensual pleasure is, it means you know, the very much to all human beings, we say, no, like we wallings. No, we are wallings, we say. What are wallings? So in Pali we call puttujana. No, puttujana. Those who are not noble persons are all wallings. All wallings. And we have a lot of, you know, the defilements in our mind. No? Defilement in our mind. So as wallings, no, we think that only this sensual pleasure is, no, the pleasant enjoyment. Pleasant enjoyment. No, we know only this one type. No, we don't know other type. So everybody is not wants to enjoy this sense pleasure. So when we want to, we say you want to enjoy sense pleasure, we want to live in a very nice house. So we like to get a very beautiful car. So we have to we like to have a lot of money. So no, this is for the enjoyment of sense pleasure. So we have to walk the whole life just to enjoy good food, good clothing, and then good, you know, the sensual pleasure. So we are just going like that. So we are living with part consciousness. No? With the lobha mula chaita, we do that consciousness. And when we don't get what we want to enjoy, then we get otosa mula chaita. And then when we cannot enjoy anything, then when our mind is just restless or wandering, we have moha mula chaita. So we live only with immoral mind, no, with immoral mind. So no, unless we know abhidhamma, no, abhidhamma, no, for myself, no, I was very religious actually since I was young. No, when I walk in the university, so in whatever university, no, I was on duty. I always formed the Buddhist association. And then I become the president. So I think, no, I know about the Buddhism quite well, I think. But only at the age of 46 years, no, I have the chance to learn Abhidhamma. Only then I have the chance to learn Abhidhamma. No? So when I know Abhidhamma, oh, I was very, very happy actually. No, because no, it is very important to our life. Actually, the most important in our life, this Abhidhamma. Because it describes about the mind in detail. No, about our existence in detail. And then, as we saw, we tell you, this is the mind that controls our fate and fortune. So, no, our soul, no, if you want to live, no, the blissfully, no, life of the light, so you have to live very morally, you have to live wisely. No, only then we know that, oh, no, without the knowledge of the, no, the Abhidhamma, I am living mostly with immoral mind, because enjoying sense pleasure most of the time. No? Just like in the United States, no, they make the statistics, how many hours, no, the each person watch television each day? They say 7 hours. 7 hours, no? So now you get the iPad, iPhone again. How many play? They're playing the iPad, iPhone. So, no, so we are living only with immoral mind, with order mind. Though their immoral minds are only 12 immoral minds. No? And then for the beautiful consciousness we have, no, up to 21 beautiful consciousnesses. And we don't know, no, how to develop the beautiful consciousnesses. No? So, and that's why the Buddha said, when most, no, living beings die, they are born in the four boats. No? So if we can see our past existence, we will see that most of the citizens are in the Bhupo boats. In the Bhupo boats. No, we have the chance to come, no, to become the human being, just one existence, because one good karma, no? Conditions are to be reborn as a human being. And if you don't know the teachings of the Buddha, so we don't know how to live morally, actually. So we go back again to the when he died, to the Bhupo boat. So the Buddha said the Bhupo boat is the permanent homes of most fallings. Most fallings, their permanent homes are just the Bhupo boat. No? So the Abhidhamma is actually very, very important, actually. Now you can understand now. No? So the Passa is, no, the Passa Vedana, they are very quite important. So we go back we get the passa, it produces feeling, and feeling beings are not so much for all living beings. They are so, no, these are very important. And we give here also here. No, the Vedana is feeling, and it is feeling that enjoys, not the taste of the sense object. So we think we enjoy it. Actually, you know, we do not exist. We say, no, the lobha, the greed, and also feeling, they enjoy the taste of the sense object. And we think that we enjoy it. We think that we enjoy it, no? Okay. And then we go to the next here. Sanya is perception. No, sanya perception is quite important also. No, so it takes note of the sense objects, no, as to the color, the form, the shape, the name, etc. So it functions as memory. So I like to cancel this. No, I like to cancel this. No, we cannot say that it is a memory actually. No, we cannot say it is a memory. And then it is, no, perception, sanya, that enables one to recognize an object that has once been perceived by the mind through the senses. The mind works as a supercomputer. The data produced by perception are transmitted from mind to mind, so they remain in the mental stream, and these old data can be recalled with mindfulness, and this is the reason why we remember what we have learned and why some people can remember their past existence, as the mental stream is not cut off at death. I found that, now, with the progress of science, we can understand the teaching of the Buddha better and better. No? So, no, like the scientists and, no, and the psychologists and philosophers, they don't know what the mind really is. So they even take that, oh, the brain functions as a mind, they say. No, the brain functions as a mind. They become, no, they even take like that. And they don't know about the properties of the mind. That the mind can produce somebody, the jhana and supernormal knowledge, and then can create all living beings. They don't know about that. So they think that, oh, the brain is only is the mind. And then in the book, in Karma Creator, I also wrote there, about the John Axel, I think his name, the name is in the book. So he is a very, the foremost neurologist in the United Kingdom. And then he made the research about the brain. Now when he made research about the brain, and then he made the statement. He said, oh, the brain functions like a computer, he said. But it is operated by a ghost, he said. By a ghost, I mean, it's something that cannot be detected by the science instrument, he said. He didn't know who operates the brain. So actually, it is the mind that operates the brain. No? And the mind itself is a supercomputer, greater computer than the mind, than the brain, actually. No? So we come to know like that. So now, when we say the perception, it is perception when you see a person. No, so we cannot the mind. No, they walk just like the instrument. No, they can take only one thing at a time. No, one thing at a time. So now this the sanya, the perception. So it takes notice of, how is the form, how is the color. How is the eye? How is the eyebrow, the nose? They have to take many times actually. And what sanya take this note? Oh, the mind is the face is like this. The eye is like this. So these data are put in the mind, just like we are putting data in our computer nowadays. No, so in the computer. No, so. When we put the data, the computer maintains them in its memory. What is its memory? In computer, which one is it? The hard disk or the no? So it is maintained in the computer, and the same thing, all the data, the taken by the sanya, are maintained in our mental stream. And that's why we do about the aggregacy. When aggregacy, saw a person, what had he learned in the past existence? Because those data are there, he could do. Oh, he like that the stenographer. Oh, she has been very, successful commercial artist. You can say like that. So the Buddha also, as soon as he saw a person. No, he can know all your past existence. No, and you can know in past existence what you have done. He can know like that. And that's why when he can teach the people very, very effectively. No, very effectively. Okay. Now just to so perception is already. And then we come to the chetana. Volition is very important again. And on this chetana, we translate it as volition or intention, we say. Chetana coordinates its concomitants, and it acts like a chief disciple or like a chief carpenter who fulfills his duties and regulates the work of others as well. Now, for example, if a chief carpenter builds a house, so he have the assistant, the carpenter, so he allot them, you do that, you do that, you do that, and he also do his work. And he supervise all these things. So the volition is just like that. No, so what is this 8 years? No, the who fulfills his duties and also regulates the work of other as well. And it prompts this chitana, prompts its concubitant to do their respective functions to accomplish each action. No, and then chitana sets the intention to perform an action and prompts its concomitant. So its concomitant means consciousness and mental factors that arise together with it. So it prompts these conscious and mental factors to do their respective functions to accomplish the action. So chitana is responsible for accomplishing an action and it is identified with the action. So the Buddha he remarked that volition is action karma. Thus I say, O monks, for as soon as prompted by volition, one does the action, be it by body, speech or mind. So the volition is identified with the karma. Karma means action. So why the chitana is called karma and how it brings an action to completion. So I will explain to you tomorrow, not today. So it will take some more time again. So we just say the prayers. And you have a program to take group photograph? Yes. Okay, we say, so we have only this one. No? The paper I get, please take that. We want that. No? So give me one also. My old one. So don't you also put like this? I like to tell them how to read the Pali word. So how to read the Pali word is also not written here. So now on the third column, now we have the saying. So we just say there.
Imaya Amanu Dhamma Patipatiya Buddham Ujjeti Imaya Amanu Dhamma Patipatiya Dhamma Ujjeti Imaya Dhamma Sanghambhujemi. With our holy practice, which is in accord with the nine supramundane dhammas, we pay obeisance to the Buddha, the Dhamma, and the Sangha. Idam me punyam asvekaya vaham atu. Idam me punyam nibbanasa patyo hotu. So I cannot see very well here. So imam no punya baga sabha sattanam dema. Imano punya bagam sabha sattanam dema. Imano punya bagam sabha sattanam dema. We share our merits with all sentient beings. May all sentient beings obtain the share of our merits and be well and happy always. Sadhu. May all you be happy and well always.